It's Wednesday and got a little audience there. I'm gonna turn that off. Welcome to CLA's Resume How-To. My name is Jennifer Herrit and I am one of the Career Services members and just wanted to say hi. So this webinar, this little live broadcast is to help those students who are looking to build their resume. Some of you haven't even started, especially the freshmen. You might have had that original resume that you needed for a class project in high school, or you had to turn something in for an assignment maybe in the last semester or two. But I'm telling you, we are here to help you. We have three career services members that are broken up in CLA for your major. We're divided between three of us. Miriam McCarley is one, and she handles the arts, communication, PR, theater, and English, and a couple others. We have Brittany Kennedy, who does a lot of the social work, psychology, political science, foreign languages, and history. And I do interdisciplinary studies, communication disorders, the two aviation majors, and communication disorders, interdisciplinary, healthcare admin, and aviation. I don't know why that was so hard for me, but I want to walk through a little bit with you. I've got a little PowerPoint that I can give you, which tells you the basics of the basic resume. So I'll share that with you in just a second, but I wanted to let you know that even though we aren't on campus, you can still reach out to us virtually. We can still have these types of meetings through Zoom, through FaceTime, whatever suits you, whatever we can do to accommodate you. If you do need to get in touch with us, we can go over your resume, we can go over cover letters, we can do virtual mock interviews, we can do all kinds of things. So if you need us, look for us on Handshake and find our emails and we'll be in touch. So let's go ahead and get started. The resume, don't let it overwhelm you. It's actually fairly easy. We do have a couple worksheets that we can give. We can email them to you. They're kind of a question and answer form. So we ask a couple pertinent questions and then you just fill them out. And that's kind of how you build your resume. Let's see, it's pretty fun actually. So let's go ahead and I'll share my screen with you now. And we'll go over this little PowerPoint. So let me see. Want to make sure I'm doing this right. Let's see. Here we go. So I can share it. All right. So let me get into my screen because this is not letting me. Hold on a second. Okay, here we go. So I'm going to share the screen with you. We're going to walk through it. Let's see. I can see myself. So how to be a standout candidate. And this is for interviews, for applications, for internships. It's a little bit of everything, but you want to stand out on your resume. And sometimes that's really hard to do on paper, especially if you're doing an application and you're one of a thousand. You want to stand out above everyone else. So how do you do that? I'm gonna show you how. So part of it is, let's see, you know, you're going through it and you want to make sure you put everything at the top. And that's just your name, your address, your phone number, all that information, your emails. There's a couple of things that I'm going to touch on right now and then I'll go back to it. The ongoing thing right now, especially in your classes, teachers are going to ask you to build your resume and you're going to want to put your name, your address, your phone number, your email, and all that information on there. And that's great. But realize that you might be sending this resume out to, you know, 50 to 100 people over the next couple of years. So as you're getting started, I want to offer this little tip that I think is a great way to kind of keep things standard. And partly is not using your Auburn email. Maybe get a professional Gmail account or Yahoo, and you can do your first name and your last name. So first name dot last name or first and last name together. Nonetheless, make it professional, whether you're using Google or Gmail, Yahoo, any of them. Just kind of keep it professional and go ahead and start that now. The other thing is if you don't want to put your phone number on there, because that's giving a lot of information to a lot of different people, consider getting a Google number. They're free, they last forever. And when people do call the number, you might think it's a little odd, but you do get your voicemails and they are transcribed into an email and then it's sent to you. So whatever professional email that you get, whether you get a Google number and a professional email, either one, you can have them forwarded to the email that you use most often. So if you are using your Auburn account, you can have all those emails forwarded to your Auburn account or to any other account that you use most. And they still stay in that email account. So every time you do an application for an internship and for a job, you can use that professional email and it keeps everything together. So if you're also using that Google number, you can put it on every application that you're gonna give. And so both those return calls, all those emails, they're all in the same place, which I think is really neat. And it keeps them all together so they don't get lost. So that's just my little bit of advice. And I'll touch on that again. So for that master resume, you wanna put everything on there. So it's every job you've ever had, every school you've ever attended outside of high school, everything you've ever done needs to go on that one master resume. And as you continue to get jobs and you continue to get experience, you wanna add everything to that master resume so that when you're applying for certain positions, you can pick all the ones that are pertinent to that one resume. So if you're going, if you have two majors, you wanna make sure that you have everything on there, you can pick and choose, put it on your resume, and go ahead and send it out for an application. So any kind of employment, all your old managers, all their contact information, you want to keep all of that together just for future reference, especially if you're keeping up with them. All right, so any your honors, your scholarships, any organizations, any attributes, any certifications, all of that needs to go on that one master resume. And that's the one you're going to keep updating. All right, so let's see what else we have. So it's a running commentary of your life. It's everything that you've done from high school on. You know, if you had a leadership position in high school, it was a pertinent leadership position, I'd say go ahead and keep it on there, but you can only keep it on there for the first semester, maybe two, depending on the internship that you're trying to get. Anything that you've published, any grants that you were awarded, anything like that goes on that master resume and you just keep it running. Okay, so now we're getting to the nuts and bolts of it. So I know you guys don't have a lot of experience, but for every 10 years of experience you get, there's gonna be one page. You can only keep those things from high school for one, maybe two semesters. If you're just going for your basic resume, one semester is all you're gonna be able to have for all that high school stuff. Around the edges, you want that 1-inch margin. Don't go beyond that unless you have a very, very full resume. Let's see, 10 to 12 points. And a professional font, that's Arial, Times New Roman. Keep it basic. When you do have a job listing or education, and you do have those awards and things that are pertinent, go ahead and bullet point them. Make them stand out. But above all, you have to keep it in chronological order and you have to be consistent. All right, so chronological order is putting the most recent first, right? And you can decide where to put your education and your experience and your involvement kind of in there. Just depends on how it looks and how it translates. Right now, coming out of college, you're gonna wanna put that education up first. So you're gonna have your name and your information, any kind of objective, and you're gonna have your education. And from there, you can kind of play with it. All right, so there's extra resume tips. So if you could be specific rather than very general, it's gonna set you apart. It's one of those things that if you've done something very specific, or if your job is more detailed, go ahead and put it in there. Nothing is too insignificant. I want you to remember that. So when you're doing that master resume, go ahead and list anything and everything. It's so much easier to pick and choose than to try to come up with new stuff. So go ahead and write down everything that you ever did. Any of those duties. Okay. Try not to overinflate things. Sometimes just being blunt is best. You know, if you try to make it sound way more than it was, it comes off as very, the word is flowery, but it comes off very unclear, because sometimes you tend to boast a little bit too much, and then if you get to the interview process, it kind of gets downplayed. So just keep it simple. Don't use I. You know, this is where the resume tricks come in. You're already talking about you. The whole page should be about you. You shouldn't have to use I. But there's a language that you should kind of be more comfortable with when it comes to the resume. And that's using those special verbs that talk about your experience and your duties that you had within the position. And I'll get to that in just a minute. We don't use slang and try to avoid conjunctions. You know, it's hard to kind of take those little things that you get comfortable doing, especially in emails, and take them out of your everyday language. But you do want someone to read that resume, and you want 5 to 7 people to look over this resume before you start sending it out. And that's at least. And we should be one of those people. Don't put in a picture. This isn't LinkedIn. You know, LinkedIn is where you can add a picture and a little bit more detail, but this is putting all of you on paper, and it's in one page. So let's see. You can include your gender and you can include your age. And let's see, there's a way that we can be very can be very fact-based with your resume without it coming off too flowery or too vague. And I know these are so hard, but you can do it. You do want to be consistent. You want everything to match. So if you're going to put your titles for your education and your experience and your involvement, they all have to be the same. Make sure your lines are right. Make sure that your margins are right. And you want it to look very, very clean, because you might only have this in front of someone for 20 to 30 seconds as they're reading it. And you want them to be able to scan it and pick out the high points and set you apart. Okay, so let's see. We're going to go through this. I feel like I'm rushing through this, but hope everyone's getting it. So let's check this real quick. I do this presentation all the time. I don't know why I'm so nervous right now. So let's see. And I can't find myself online, so I don't know where the chats are. So let's see. Let me look real quick. It's got to be on here somewhere. Let me see. Okay, here I am. Okay, so I don't have any questions so far. It makes me happy. Okay, at least I think so. Let me double check. I just know I look kind of goofy online as I look at myself. All right, let's see. Let's go to the next page. Okay, so what employers are looking for, which is very important, and that's where we get into those core competencies. And this is where the wording comes in. So it's using verbs and your duties and pairing them together to come across that you've done these jobs that have this relevant experience. And part of that is those written communication skills, those problem solving skills, leadership, teamwork, showing that you have initiative, and above all, you have passion, that you like what you're doing, whether it's being a nanny, whether it's working at Zaxby's. There's passion there and there's some work ethic. Leadership is huge, and whether you can get that through a student organization, through the university having a position, or just through your job, leadership is going to come across. Even if you're not in a management role, you can still show leadership. Detail-oriented, of course, everyone's heard that term, and technical skills. All of that can be conveyed through action verbs, through good writing on your resume, making sure that there's attention to detail, even on your resume, and making it look good. Anyone can do it, and we can help you. So let's go ahead and see. Let's look at one of them that we can talk about. So oral written communication skills, the employers want to see it, and they rate it on a scale of out of 5 as 3.5 or 3.49. So those are so important. Even higher than that is that critical thinking and problem solving skills. If you have any kind of computer experience, that's going to be a big role. But, you know, having that management, that's probably one of the least important ones that they think of. And that's because not all managers actually have leadership skills. Sometimes it's their employees that have more leadership skills. So try to convey that through that resume. All right, let's see. So on the screen now is this page that we use with almost every student that comes in. And these are those verbs that we were talking about. We can send this to you and we can set up this meeting and we can go over it. What we'd like to do is say, pick 10 of these that are relevant to your positions, your previous positions, and what you want to convey to employers. You know, so you go through them and you read through them. If it's within the research realm, if it's in the creative realm, go ahead and what speaks to you. So we ask you to circle 10 of them and we start to try to find roles you've done previously to fit them in. Let's see, and so we, you know, it's a PowerPoint presentation, so we have some of them circled. But, you know, impact is a great one. Enhanced, you know, saying that you've assisted someone. It's so hard to use that word because, I mean, within a position, you can assist somebody by bringing them coffee, but you can also assist them by writing code. You know, so it's so broad, and try not to be that broad. Try to bring that in, hone in on that, to talk about things that you've done directly within a position. So let's see, like enhanced is nice. You know, if you worked as a team, did you enhance that team? Did you surpass a goal? I mean, there's all kinds of these words, and they really do come across as strengthening words to me. And they really do elevate the language within your resume. It's easy to say that you have customer service because you worked at Zaxby's, but that doesn't always get conveyed the same way. Customer service is great, but did you have customer service? Did you help every customer that came through? Were you their first point of contact? What is it about that position? There's nothing too small. All right, so if you wanted to go in and set up an appointment with us, we will go through this back and forth a few times just to make sure that you understand what the words mean, how we're going to use them, how we're going to elevate the language within your resume. Let's see, because we want you to be on that paper. Okay, so I'm trying to get this to click. There we go. The transferable skills that you're going to find within the College of Liberal Arts are speaking, writing, analytical skills, interpersonal skills, problem solving, and adaptability. So we're going to look over those verbs, circle the verbs, and put them into your current or your past experience. So we do ask you, just like it says, to go through and star the ones or circle them, and then write sentences that qualify those words. You know, using numbers always helps. If you had a goal and you surpassed it, what percentage did you surpass? Did you surpass it? Was it 105%? Was it 110%? Did you get, you know, 10 different goals and you met all of them? Did you exceed the goals? You know, we need that information. So when you're doing that master resume, that's what you're going to be doing. It's writing down every little thing, every project that you worked on, every team project, every individual project. What all did you do? We want to know. And even if you put that into plain language, we can look over it and help you elevate it and pick out those ones that are pertinent and put them on that resume. All right, so here is the biggest part. This is a sample resume that I pulled. And at the top, it's very, very clean. They kept the margins on the sides. There's a good use of white space. Everything's at the top, your name, your address, your city, state, zip, your email, and your phone number. And again, going back to that Google name and number, and you're giving them your address, your city, state, zip, and you're going to give them your email, and you're going to give them your phone number. Just think about it. It's a lot of information you're giving out. So just consider doing your city, state, zip, your professional email, and your Google phone number. Now it keeps it kind of vague, but you still get the same information, and they can still contact you the same way. All right, so you don't always have to put the topics in the center. You can always put them to the left. But if you're going to put them to the left, make sure that they stand apart. So italicize them, kill that word, italicize them, make them a little bit larger. But whatever you do to the top one, you're going to do it to each one. I do like how they put the university here. What we need are dates, and I like them over on the right. I think that's pretty standard. It's easy to read. You have the university, you have your degree. If there's any thesis, you can have that, any relevant coursework, and that's pertinent in certain fields. They're more technical fields, especially with aviation or communication disorders. They want to see that you've taken certain classes. And then you have you also have the address, state, spell out your information if you can, and your graduation date. So when do you graduate? Expected graduation date of 2022. Did you graduate in 2019? Want to see that information. If you have any study abroad experience, want to know where you went and how long you were there and what you studied. You know, were you on a project there? Did you have any relevant coursework? Did you volunteer for something? I want to see it. This one says the name of the high school. Again, that's only for your first semester. You've got to take that off. Let that be a talking point if you make it to the interview. Right, and then we go to experience. Want the organization, where they're located, what position you held underneath the company. Do not give me the position before the company. And then how long were you there? Then we start with the bullet points. you notice that a lot of them start with action verbs. That's where it's going to be important for that blue page back here. Here is where you're going to start qualifying this position. So did you surpass? Did you enhance? All of those words should be on the beginning of these bullet points. What did you do? How was it important? How did you help the goals of the company, your team? Did you have a leadership position? You know, if it's within the same company, say that you started in one position and then you moved higher up or you moved to a different position, you can give me the same company and different titles and different responsibilities underneath. So let's see. If you have any leadership experience, I want the organization. I want your role or your title within that organization. And then what did you do? Did you work on a project? Again, project, did you enhance it? Did you surpass it? Did you complete it? Did you work as a team? Working with a team, the team did X, Y, Z. I want that information. And then if you have any skills, and this is comes and goes, it just kind of depends on how long you've been in school or if you have any special skills and hobbies that relate to your future career. Do you know any programming languages? Do you have any extra certifications? If you don't, start looking for some. You want to set yourself apart, start looking on LinkedIn for people that are in the position that you want for the future and see what certifications they have. There's something that you can achieve while you're in school, do it, especially if it's free. A lot of these certifications you can do for free. So that's a no-brainer, especially while we're in quarantine. And I know we're all tired of being behind the computer, but it's a great way to use your time. And then sometimes the interests go a long way of setting you apart. If it's something really cool, put them on there. When you bring your resume to us, we'll tell you. Like, don't put basket weaving on there. But if you do like to volunteer or you do have an interest that you've started your own nonprofit or something crazy, put it on there. Set yourself apart. Go bold. All right, so here's another resume. So this is your basic standard resume. Over here, we have one that's a little bit different. You're going to see in certain majors, you're going to have to put a little bit more pizzazz into them. And this is one. This one, she's been in position, many positions for quite some time, but the layout is different. I wanted you to see it. So as you advance, if you're in certain majors, especially PR, you're going to have to put a little bit more pizzazz into them. This is something that you wouldn't give for business. You know, if you're going into a very standard business for a standard position, this is not going to be it. But the layout is different. She puts her experience first, skills, the budgets that she's managed, which is important if you're going into certain fields, how much you can handle. And then she puts her education at the bottom, but you can also see that she graduated a while back. So she's been in many, many careers over the last couple of years. So it's very different from what most of you will be turning in. But it's very nice. She's put her companies at the top for her clients. And she's using icons, which isn't recognizable. And this one is actually a little bit more standard. But again, it's in a certain field. So you need to look at this. There's no picture on this one, which is nice. She has her skills and her contact information on the left. She's done a personal profile. She's got a lot of information. And again, her high school stuff is on here. But if you notice that she was valedictorian. She was actually president and held like positional roles within certain groups. So I think stuff, if you're starting out, that's something that might be good to put on there, especially if you're valedictorian or you held some kind of president or director position within your groups. But again, that has to come off at some point. So she's worked as a senior designer and a design assistant. So two different companies, but she's listed them out. Do you notice that she didn't put the company above it? And that's kind of a no-no. You always put the company first. So just giving you some information. Again, when you start looking for jobs and looking at the resumes and the requirements that are involved, when you look at that job, that internship, you're going to see a lot of those keywords. If you can relate to those keywords that are in the detailed description, you're going to try to fit those back into your resume. You know, if they're looking for detail-oriented people and you are someone that's detail-oriented and you can show that through your previous experience, start making those connections. Let's see. If you want to reach out to alumni, you can become a member of our alumni fire and meet up, get a mentor, and you guys can start talking, especially if they're in a position that you want. Yeah, it's a good experience to have. Let them look at your resume. Let them tell you what they see and what you should be putting on there. For personal connections, of course, we're going to go to LinkedIn. LinkedIn's where you're going to start looking, like I mentioned before. Find people that are in companies that you want to be in and positions and roles that you want to do in the future, and start looking at their certifications, look at how they were involved. What languages do they know? What certifications do they have? What experience do they have? And then potentially connect to them. Reach out. What's the harm? The worst they can say is no. Come to all of our events. If you're looking at grad school, we have all kinds of events. We have this resume drop that we're doing over the summer. I'm going to show you that in just a second. Reach out to us. We're at home too. Let's see. So here's where we tell you that even though you have your resume and it's built and we've been working with you and you start doing applications for internships and for jobs, be patient. Don't get discouraged. The average time from job posting to interview is 38 days. The average time from interview to offer is another 24 days. So don't get discouraged. Things do take time. And lastly, right here is our I'll be link for the summer resume review. This is a Qualtrics form. It's so basic. You know, you log on, give me a little bit of information about yourself, and then drop your resume in PDF form. There's a little space where you can upload it. Upload it. It'll ding us, actually individually based on what your major is, and we'll contact you. We'll have your resume already. We'll be able to look at it, review it, and then we'll set up a time where we can just talk to you for about 5 to 10 minutes, go through it, we'll critique it, send it to you, you can work on it, you can drop it again, and we'll keep working on it. No, it's not hard. We're trying to make it as easy as possible for us to help you. So help me help you. If you have any questions, give you my information, connect to us. We are pretty active on Instagram. You can keep up with us pretty regularly. There's postings almost every day. Talk about our events, talk about everything we have going on, and reach out to us. We don't bite, I promise. All right, here's my information. Usually we're in 308 Titchener and 305 Titchener. Again, we'll be virtual until August 8th, but if you need us, reach out to us. Yep. Handshake is a great place to find us if you want to schedule an appointment, or just find us through the CLA webpage. If you have any questions, find us. And good luck with your resume. Drop it in that Qualtrics form here, and let's start working. Thanks, guys.